Hello learners, welcome to UGC EPG Pathshala. We shall discuss today climatology module 23, Thornwaite's climatic classification. Principal investigator Professor M.S. Siddiqui from Jamia. Paper coordinator Dr. Ramashree Prasad and content writer myself Dr. Kanchan Singh from Meerut. Content reviewer Dr. Ramashree Prasad from Bhim Rao Ambedkar College, University of Delhi. Thornwaite's climatic classification introduction, learning objectives, historical development in Thornwaite's climatic classification, method of calculation, PET index, heat index, moisture index, thermal index, design of classification, first capital alphabet for moisture regimes, second capital alphabet with dash for thermal provinces, third small alphabet for seasonal surplus or deficit of moisture, aridity index for humid climates, humidity index for arid climates, water balance and its explanation, soil water balance, special distribution of world climates, criticism of the classification, climates of India by Thornwaite, difference between Köppen and Thornwaite's classification of climates, summary and conclusions, references, web links, multiple choice questions and answer keys. Thornwaite's classification introduction. Charles Warren Thornwaite, an American climatologist, attempted classification of world climates in 1931. The climatic classification was revised and improved further in 1948. Classification incorporates evaporation, evapotranspiration, temperature, precipitation information, and is now widely used in studying the animal species diversity, potential impacts of climate change. Thornwaite's classification is an improved and modified form of Köppen's classification of climates. It is assumed that precipitation, temperature, and plant association are strongly correlated. Natural vegetation is a true representation or product of the climate. It is an outcome of precipitation and thermal conditions prevailing at a specific place over a period of time. Growth of natural vegetation not only depended upon precipitation alone, but also on the evaporation and evapotranspiration. Climates of potential evaporation by mean total amount of water vaporized and transpirized over a period of time in an area is now available. Learning objectives: after studying this module, you will be able to explain the design of climatic classification, name various measurements that characterize a climatic group, explain combination of letters, discuss the utility of water balance, state the climatic conditions during different seasons, historical development in Thornwaite's classification. Being a professor of climatology, Thornwaite wrote a research paper entitled Climates of North America According to a New Classification. It was published in 1931 in Geographical Review, Volume 21. Later on in 1946, Thornwaite attempted a study on moisture factor in climate. The article was published in 1948 in Transactions of American Geophysics Union, Volume 27. Modified version of Thornwaite's classification was published in 1948, entitled An Approach Towards Rational Classification of Climates in Geographical Review in Volume 38. Further elaborated work of Thornwaite in association with Mather was published in 1955 in a seminal research article on water balance in climatology, volume 8. Both the scholars have written instruction manuals, tables for computing evapotranspiration and water balance. In 1957, which was published in climatology, volume 10, Thornwaite is credited to have established the laboratory of climatology at Drexel Institute of Technology, Centerton, New Jersey, USA. These tables and manuals are even now being used across the world for studies related to classification of climates and climate change assessments. Studies on water balance are now widely used to assess the soil moisture and surplus and deficit situations of water at any place. Ribeiro and Ricardo, 2011, published an article on the evapotranspiration in climate classification. Similarly, Das, 2015, published an article on water balance and climatic classification of tropical city Delhi, India. The applied aspect of the work relates to disciplines such as hydrology, agriculture, ecosystem situation, human health and medical sciences. Method of calculation. Thornvett used a set of indices to work out classification of climates. These indices used in the exercise are potential evapotranspiration, PET index, heat index, I, moisture index, MI, and thermal index, TI. The potential evapotranspiration, PET, is calculated from mean monthly temperature in degree Celsius in association with day length for a 30-day month, 12-hour days. Heat index, I, is worked out by monthly mean heat index adjusted for number of hours of daylight and days in a specific month. It is linked to mean monthly air temperature. Moisture index, MI, is worked out by subtracting PET values with precipitation, P, divided by PET and coefficient multiplied by 100. Thermal index, TI, is worked out by adding minimum temperature values to maximum and sum divided by the two. Equation from each of the indexes given below. PET index, potential evapotranspiration, is worked out using mean monthly air temperature in degree Celsius. PE is equal to 1.6 within bracket 10 TA, where PE is a monthly potential evapotranspiration in centimeters. TA is monthly air temperature in degree Celsius. A is a cubic function of I, and that is 1.72 and multiplied by 10.3. The above equation and values have been derived from Thornvett's article published in Geographical Review, volume 38, 1948. Heat index refers to the mean monthly air temperature degree Celsius for each month from month 1st to month 12th in degree Celsius. It is further adjusted to number of hours of daylight and days of the month. Total values of temperature were then divided by 5, a constant value of average. The coefficient is derived by value of 1.514 refers to some total temperature values adjusted to hours of daylight divided by a constant value. The final index is further raised to the power of 1.514 to ascertain the heat index. I is an annual heat index given by mean heat index of nth month, that is ET is equal to 1.60 LA within bracket 10 T plus divided by IT. A ET monthly PET in centimeters, LA adjustment of the number of hours of the daylight and days in month of depends on latitude. T mean monthly air temperature in degree Celsius, IT total of 12 monthly values of heat index, that is I is equal to T upon 5, 1.514. A is an empirical constant, T, 6.75 multiplied by 10 point minus 7 liters, 3.7, 7.71, 10 multiplied by 10.5. Moisture index, the proportion of precipitation that ultimately remains available for practical purposes after evaporation is known as moisture index. It is being worked out by subtracting the value of potential evapotranspiration from precipitation and balance is divided by potential evapotranspiration PET. The coefficient is then multiplied by 100 to get the moisture index MI. P minus PET divided by PET then divided by 100, where P is precipitation, PET is potential evapotranspiration, thermal index, the index being worked out by adding together the maximum temperature value of each day for the month and the sum divided by total number of days in the month. Similarly, average minimum temperature is also worked out by adding together diurnal minimum temperature values for a month and the sum divided by the total number of days in the month. Thermal index is calculated by addition of average maximum temperature and average minimum temperature and the sum divided by 2. Thermal index is thus the middlemost value lying between the maximum and minimum values of temperature. Ti is equal to T max plus T minimum divided by 2, where T max is maximum, T min is minimum temperature. Monthly water surplus, that is S, or deficit is D, is calculated from a moisture budget assessment including stored soil moisture, a scheme of moisture index MI, humidity provinces expressed in capital letter alphabets, rainfall in centimeters, precipitation effectiveness based on heat, that is I, and moisture indexes indices M, thermal provinces expressed in capital alphabets with superscripts dash is presented in table 1. Heat and thermal indices are extremely useful in working out precipitation effectiveness, which in its turn is an important indicator of plant growth. Heat index refers to hours of sunlight and air temperature, whereas thermal index relates to average thermal condition, that is sum total of maximum and minimum temperature divided by 2. The table below summarizes different indices and their limits. Thornwaite's classification is thus based on 2 important indices, that is PE, precipitation effectiveness. Effectiveness of precipitation depends upon the distribution pattern of rainfall in a calendar year and evaporation of moisture back to the atmosphere through different surfaces and means. Seasonal deficiency and surplus of rainfall affects plant growth significantly. Temperature efficiency relates to variation in temperature and its role in the growth of plants. Equatorial areas where sunlight and temperature both are usually very high with insignificant variation in a calendar year, growth of plant remains high. Contrary to it, arid areas reflect high variation in temperature and sunlight, hence plant growth is retarded significantly. Potential evaporation is thus an index of temperature efficiency design of classification. Thornwaite's design of climate classification is a combination of 3 later alphabets. First alphabet used in the major climate classification is any one of the English capital letter from A to E, which denotes world's 5 moisture regimes. Further subdivision in a major climate is expressed by small numerical values such as 1, 2, 3, denoting variation within moisture regimes. These are A, that is wet or perhumid with moisture index as 100, PE, moisture index 127, vegetation rainforest, E, B, humid 20 to 100, and PE index 64 to 127, and type of vegetation is forest. C is the moist subhumid with moisture index 0 to 20. PE index is 32.63 and type of vegetation is grasslands. D is dry subhumid with moisture index 30, minus 30 to 0. PE index is 16 to 31 and type of vegetation is steppe. E is arid, E with moisture index minus 100 to minus 67. PE index is less than 16 and type of vegetation is desert. The second letter used in climatic classification is also an English alphabet, capital alphabet, superscript with dash. It denotes the thermal province. Thornwaite has divided world into 6 thermal provinces. They are expressed as A dash, that means megathermal, tropical, TE index is 127. B dash is mesothermal, expressed as B1, B2, B3, B4, TE index is 64 to 127. C dash is a microthermal, TE index is 32 to 63. D dash is taiga, TE index is 16 to 31. E dash is tundra, T index is 1 to 15, F dash is frost, T index is 0. Based on the moisture and thermal indices, 9 major climates were identified. Third letter in combination of alphabets is denoted by a set of 8 small English alphabets. They are used to express seasonal pattern of availability of moisture from acute deficit to abundant surplus situations. The expression of small alphabets is explained below. Rainfall adequate in all the year, that is small r. Rainfall deficient in all the seasons, that is small d. Rainfall deficient in normal during winter season is small w. Rainfall deficient normal during summer is small s. Aridity index for humid climates. Moisture deficit acute during winter, that is w2. Moisture deficit acute during summer is s2. Humidity index for arid climates, moisture surplus abundant during winter is S2. Moisture surplus abundant during summer is W2. Thornwaite has been concerned with working out seasonal deficiency of moisture in humid climates, which appears to be the cause of dryness and apparently halting the growth of plants for a specific period. Similarly, places in arid climates do represent moisture surplus seasonally, which serve as a storage of soil moisture and a basis for the growth of plant as grasslands and xerophytes. Thus, precipitation effectiveness P and temperature efficiency T are closely associated and are expressions of vegetation type. Both the indices record high values where variation in distribution pattern of rainfall and temperature reflect the variation. Contrary to this, both the indices record low values if the distribution pattern of rainfall and temperature reflect high variation. However, both the indices are aimed at a common point of reference, that is vegetation, which is true representation of a climate type. The third alphabet classification is largely based on the seasonal characteristics of precipitation. Following four small alphabets were used to denote the seasonal characteristics of rainfall. Based on four seasonal characteristics of rainfall, 20 climatic divisions have been recognized. They are presented in Table 2. Besides surplus and deficit rainfall at seasonal level, Thornwaite has also considered the level of seasonal moisture deficiency for humid climates and seasonal abundance of moisture for arid climates as a crucial element in plant growth and characterization of climates. As such, an attempt was made to work out season-specific moisture deficiency from normal to acute for humid climates and moisture surplus from normal to abundant for arid climates. To make it distinct from normal situation, seasonal characteristics were further assigned with numerical values, that is M is equal to IH minus 0.6 IA or M is equal to 100 A alpha minus 60 beta divided by Y, where IH is the index of humidity, IA is the index of aridity, alpha is a water surplus and beta is the water deficit. Gamma is the water need for potential evapotranspiration. The above concept relates to the status of moisture at a specific place. If alpha exceeds the potential evapotranspiration, that is PET, or water need, Y, the situation is termed as humid. Similarly, if beta exceeds the potential evapotranspiration, PET, or water need, Y, the situation is termed as arid. Seasonal characteristics are explained below. Aridity index for humid climates, that is A, B and C2. Proportion of moisture deficit is denoted by no moisture deficit, that is 0 to 10 is equal to R. That means rainfall throughout the year. Moisture deficit normal during summer season is 10 to 20, that is S. Moisture deficit normal during winter season 10 to 20, that is W. Moisture deficit acute below 20%. Above 20% in winter, that is W2, moisture deficit acute above 20% in summer, that is S2, humidity index for arid climate C1, D and E. Proportion of moisture surplus is denoted by water surplus negligible, that is 0 to 16.7, that D, winter moisture surplus normal from 16.7 to 33.3 is equal to S. Summer moisture surplus normal is 16.7 to 33.3 W. Moisture surplus abundant, that is above 33.3% in summer. Moisture surplus abundant 33 in winter. The seasonal variation of effective moisture concentration temperature efficiency has been worked out, refined for the development classification expressed in the evapotranspiration, though they are not linked to common cause and are evidently the result of different causes. The potential evapotranspiration rates increase with an increase in temperature and decrease in relative humidity, which varies with precipitation. In Indian situation, rates increase steadily from January to May with increasing temperature and aridity, followed by a rapid decline from June onwards with onset of summer monsoon. The minimum is ultimately reached in the month of August, which also records the heaviest rainfall and resultant humidity. The effect of relative humidity on the rates may be seen from examples of months of April and July, which have mean maximum temperature of 36 degrees Celsius and 34 degrees Celsius respectively, and corresponding potential evapotranspiration rates of 30 and 15 centimeters. A gradual rise in rate is noted from September with a slight increase in air temperature following a decline in rainfall and cloudiness. However, the rise in rates does not continue beyond October because of the approaching cold season. The actual evapotranspiration, as distinct from potential evapotranspiration, depends upon the amount of water actually available for the growth of plants. As such, it is function of precipitation provided there is no soil moisture. Recharge by capillary action from the plant from water table, and that artificial irrigation is not prevalent. Further, the actual evapotranspiration in any month will be less than the equal to the corresponding potential evapotranspiration depends upon the amount of water actually available for the growth of plants. As such, it is a function of precipitation provided there is no soil moisture recharge by capillary action from water table, and that artificial irrigation is not prevalent. Further, the actual evapotranspiration in any month will be less than the less than or equal to corresponding potential evapotranspiration. According to an existence or otherwise of a water deficit in that month, as such, actual equals the potential only in July, August and September, when water deficit is non-existent. Soil water balance. Thornwett and Mather developed a method for estimating the recharge, storage and abstraction in the process of water percolation to subsoil layers. Thornwett is a climatologist. As a climatologist, developed the concept of soil moisture balance, and he preferred to use it as the foundation of his climate system. He was convinced that soil moisture balance represents availability of moisture for plants and assessment of the availability of surplus moisture to supply stream flow and groundwater. This concept implies that precipitation alone does not indicate the amount of water actually available to plant. The moisture requirement of plants become higher as temperature increases. A schematic illustration is presented below, illustrates that rain and irrigation are two sources of soil moisture. Evaporation and transpiration are the two ways of moisture transfer to atmosphere. Runoff and percolation are the processes of water flow. Stored soil water has deep percolation and upward movement of soil moisture. The method developed by Thornwett is given below. Recharge is equal to precipitation plus snow melt plus inflow minus sources. Interruption by various means, R is equal to P minus 1 A, P plus soil mixture minus IA, where R is the runoff. R is the runoff, P is daily precipitation, S maximum is the maximum soil moisture holding capacity, and I is the initial obstruction, the amount of precipitation that must fall before any runoff is generated. The initial obstruction IA term is used to a maximum storage term Smax as follows. IA is equal to 0.2 into Smax. The maximum storage term is defined by the curve number of land minus cover type under consideration. Smax is equal to 1000 minus 10 upon CN, this is the fourth. Thus, it has been established that availability of water is crucial to the survival and growth of plants and animals, including humans. Currently, the world is faced with the water crisis and declining biodiversity. Thornwett could perceive the prospective crisis of water nearly 70 years before, and for that, he developed the method and diagram to represent the situation so that possible solutions could be searched out. This is given in figure 2. Three parameters, that is P, T and seasonal characteristics of surplus and deficit moisture conditions, formed the basis of dividing world into 32 types of climates. Moisture provinces A and E have three subdivisions in each. Similarly, B and D moisture provinces have 7 and 6 subdivisions each, while C moisture province has a maximum of 10 subdivisions. Thermal provinces D, E and F have been represented by single climate type without having further subdivisions in them. Major climate types have been presented in a table and summer concentration thermal efficiency has been presented by Thornwett. A map accessed is also given, it is easy to recognize polar climates at the top, closely followed by tundra type climate towards south. Close to the equator, one can notice A, B and C type of climates given successively northward. Desert climates D type or E type are recognizable along the margins of tropical and subtropical belts. Map showing climatic divisions of the world as per Thunberg classification is presented in figure 3. Special distribution of world climates. The pattern of special distribution of climate reveals the pattern of zonation from equator to poles. While equatorial areas with high PE and TE index values express luxuriant vegetation in the form of rainforest, tundra and polar areas with low PE and TE indices express scanty and limited vegetation. Similarly, eastern coasts in subtropical areas have high PE values and moderate TE values and thus have forests which are mostly deciduous in nature, while humid climates A, B and C are characterized by normal seasonal deficiency of moisture. Arid climates D and E do have normal seasonal surplus of moisture in at least one season. Thus, dry climates usually occupy a large place in interior parts of the continents. The western margins of the continents in the tropics and eastern margins of the subtropics and temperate zones. London is an example of humid oceanic climate, while Athens, Greece is an example of mild winter Mediterranean climate. Lima, Peru represented dry continental climate, while Denver in USA humid continental climate. La Paz, Bolivia, at an altitude of 3664 meters above sea level, has a very low PE and very low TE index. It represents highland climate, referred to figure 3. Criticism of the classification. Thunberg's classification of the world climates is improved qualitatively. However, classification seems to have ignored the role of prevailing winds, relative humidity, air pressure, and air masses. The classification system has proved most satisfactory in case of North America, where vegetation boundaries nearly coincide with particular PE values, but it is not satisfactory for tropical and semi-arid areas. The calculation of soil moisture balance for different natural regions and vegetation zones poses basic problem. Several combinations at local and regional levels increase complexity, obscuring clarity of classification. Availability of data for all the meteorological variables over time and space is a serious problem. Despite being an improved classification qualitatively, it is being less used and of limited application because of its complex nature. Thunberg's classification of the world climate is improved qualitatively. However, classification of climate seems to have ignored the role of relief position of sun with reference to incidence of solar radiation on the earth, current issues of global warming, climate change, increasing incidence of extreme events does not find place in Thunberg's classification of world climates. Climates of India. Thunberg's modified scheme of classification 1948 have been explained with the help of a map. Results reveal that per humid A type of climates, where two distinct clusters in India are found, one in northeastern part of India, excluding some parts of plains of Assam and adjoining Nagaland. Second cluster is found along Malabar coastal region. The B type of climate, that is humid, is found in northern part of the states of West Bengal, Sikkim and parts of Assam Valley. It is also found along Western Ghat Mountains in proximity to Malabar coast. The C type of moist subhumid of climate is experienced in large parts of Orissa, Jharkhand, Eastern Bihar and Chhattisgarh regions. A small zone of moist subhumid climate is also experienced along Nilgiri Hills, Western Ghat Mountains and along coastal Maharashtra. The C2 dry subhumid type of climate is found in large parts of peninsular India, in northern plains and along Tamil Nadu coast. Semi-arid D type of climate is experienced in southern parts of Punjab, Haryana plains, Mathura Agra belt, eastern Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh and central Tamil Nadu. The arid E-type climates are found in three major pockets. Northernmost pocket of E-type of climate is found in Himalayan states of Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. The second major pocket of E-type of climate is found in western parts of Rajasthan state and large parts of Gujarat state, including Kutch and Kathiawar regions. Besides these arid regions, a relatively small pocket of E-type of climate is also found in parts of northeastern Maharashtra adjoining Andhra Pradesh. This can be seen in figure. Difference in classification of climates by Köppen and Thornwett. The scheme of classification of world climates presented by scholars Köppen and Thornwett present marked difference in arrangement of alphabets, their combination and indices. For example, arid and semi-arid climates find second place in the arrangement of Köppen's scheme of classification, whereas these climates find fourth and fifth place in Thornwett's classification. While Köppen seems to attach higher weightage to contrasting climatic characters, Thornwett seems to attach higher weightage to gradual succession of characteristics from humid to arid. Köppen's scheme is more popular as it involves simple calculations of broad parameters, whereas Thornwett's scheme requires rigorous calculation of moisture conditions, soil moisture balance, and acute shortage and abundance of surplus condition. Therefore, the two scholars have contributed significantly in advancing our understanding about climatic elements, climate change, and its impact assessment in life forms on the earth. Summary and conclusions. Thornwett's classification of world climate is based on precipitation and temperature indices to explain the vegetation. Classification provides an efficient way to describe biotic life of plants and animals through precipitation and temperature and their seasonality. Influences of climates are well reflected in both plants as well as animal life forms, and as such, exercise direct influence on ecosystem and biodiversity. Issues related to water balance is unique, and it is now widely used in hydrology, agriculture, medical sciences, biological studies, etc. Therefore, Thornwett's scheme of classification is significant. Ecology also, as it considers the aspect of moisture recharge, porosity, permeability, and soil, etc. Most valuable contribution of Thornwett is his concept of evaporation and evapotranspiration. It has helped in studying water balance in applied sense. Not only devising equations for identification of climate group, Thornwett has also established a laboratory of climatology at Drexel Institute of Technology, Centerton, New Jersey. Instruments and tables were also provided for solving the calculation. Similar, the statistical tables, mathematical calculation tables were developed by Thornwett, and they are now widely used for climatic classification. Methods and means of representation is simple and helps in devising solution for increasing incidence of scarcity of water, which world is currently faced. The classification is widely used to map long-term climate and associated ecological conditions. It is simple and easy to work out. The type of climate, if alphabetical letter codes are known. Similarly, if data on temperature and precipitation seasonality is available, it is easy to code the climate type. With the increasing incidence of extreme climate events, there has been an increasing interest in using the classification to identify changes in climate and potential changes in different life forms such as plants, animals, and humans. Most useful significance of Thornwett's climate classification is that it helps to predict the dominant vegetation type based on climatic data and vice versa. From different scientific reports, it has been established that more than 5% of all the land area worldwide had moved from wetter and colder classifications to drier and hotter classification of climates. The concept of water balance is essential to monitor the requirement of water for crops in different seasons. Then there are references which are available, say the assessment, water balance and climatic classification, Tropical City of Delhi, American Journal, and other references, Lely John, Problems in the Classification of Climates, Annals of Association of American Geographers, Volume 54, December, Mathur Aran, Study of Groundwater Hydrology, District Meerut, Uttar Pradesh, India, PhD thesis published by Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi, Rivero, Antonio, Da Kunha, Ricards, Edgar Scheffler, Evaporation in Climate Classification, Evaporation from Measurement to Agricultural and Environmental Application, Dr. Giacomi Girosa, edited the book Thornwett, CW and Climates of North America according to new classification, Geographical Review. Then again, an article by Thornwett in 1946, The Moisture Factor in Climate it is published in Transaction of American Geophysics Union, volume 27, page 4148, Thornwett, An Approach Towards a Rational Classification of Climate, published in 1948, Geographical Review, volume 38, number 1, 55 to 94. Thornwett and Mather, they developed water balance, published in Climatology, volume 8, number 1, Laboratory of Climatology at Digital Institute of Technology, Centerton, New Jersey. Thornwett and Mather again published an book, Instructions and Tables for Computing Potential Evapotranspiration and Water Balance, Climatology, volume 10. It is again from New Jersey. Then there are certain external links, web links, which have been provided for ready reference. They could be seen, and further details, if somebody is interested, they can go through these links and they can find some of the detailed works of Thornwett's classification and further modifications done by several other scholars at the global level and at different levels. So it's an important, we have given multiple choice questions. Question number one, Charles Warren Thornwett was a Russian climatologist, German climatologist, American climatologist, or British climatologist? Second, in which of the following years C.W. Thornwett revised and modified his classification of world climates? 31, 54, 1936, or 1948. Third, P index for moisture subhumid climate is 64 to 127, 32 to 63, 127, 16 to 31, which is for this subhumid climate. T index for arid climate is 1 to 15, 16 to 31, 32 to 63, or 64 to 127. How many thermal provinces of the world have been identified in Thornwett's scheme of climate classification? There are 6, 7, 5, 8. The next question is 6th. In which of the following years Thornwett and Mather developed the concept of soil water balance? 31, 48, 55, or 57? Next, when Thornwett considered the idea of moisture factor in climate, is it 48? Is it 1946? 1955 or 1957. Eighth, the letter E in Thornwett's classification belongs to which type of vegetation? Grassland vegetation, steppe vegetation, desert vegetation, forest vegetation, which is the, this is two. Ninth is, according to Thornwett, alphabet B belongs to which of the following thermal provinces? Mesothermal, tropical, taiga, microthermal. And the final question, 10th, is how many thermal zones have been identified by Thornwett based on average annual thermal efficiency and summer concentration, 5, 6, 9, or 7. Then the key is provided for question number 1, C is a correct answer, question number 2, D is correct, question number 3, B is correct, 4th, A is correct, 5th, again A is correct, 6th, D is a correct answer, 7th, B is correct answer, 8th, C is, 9th, B, and for 10th, it is C, which is a correct answer. Thank you very much.